all my life. Never seen anything like it.
What would you compare it to?
Oh, I don't know. It's like a tornado went through or disaster.
Thousands of residents in Carroll County are feeling powerless tonight. The ice storm has left them in the dark, and there's a good chance they'll stay that way for a while.
Power crews say it could be days before power is restored. News Channel 8's Carrie Gavin has traveled to two of the hardest hit communities in Carroll County, Carroll itself and the nearby town of Breda. Carrie joins us live from Breda via News Star 8 with more. So, looks and sounds pretty bad, Carrie.
It's pretty nasty out. You know, they say 57% of the residents in Carroll County do not have power. Breda, the whole town doesn't have power. You can see behind me, they're downtown. No power whatsoever. You know, it's kind of weird to see people out after an ice storm, out and about driving, but that's just what a lot of residents in Breda are doing tonight because it's the only way they can get heat from their cars. But it seems like heat is the least of their concerns.
Welcome to the small town of Breda. Population 500. Residents without power 500.
Probably a good 2 inches on everything. Oh no, every tree, all everything. It's not good at all.
We've never had one like this with an inch of ice and this much snow on the ground. No, this is as bad as it's been.
For the past 2 days, Breda residents have been doing their best to stay warm. Those like Chad Underberg call themselves lucky thanks to this generator.
We got the furnace going. We regulate between the refrigerator, freezer, whatever we can, you know, and lights at night.
City crews and tree trimmers are hard at work with word that power crews are on the way.
Right now, the last couple days, we've been clearing lines, mostly the primaries, things like that.
Its service line has come down twice from limbs, so they're going to put the new service line back up. We're going to take off a bunch of this tree.
Dave Snyder says he's still catching up from an ice storm 3 weeks ago. Today's job is a little more dangerous than
yesterday. I started and there were so many limbs still falling. I stopped. It was too dangerous and it's still dangerous.
It's crackling everywhere. You just stick around and wait. Something's going to fall.
And not 10 minutes later, we saw what Chad was talking about.
The town, you know, you got things like that going on all the time. So, did you catch that?
It's no wonder why those in Breda are trying to stay inside.
Nervous. Scared. No. Little guys like this running around, never know a branch is going to fall.
Now they're hoping that Mother Nature doesn't take a turn for the worse.
Oh, I think it's very devastating. I'm not sure we've seen the worst yet. Because it's supposed to get windy. If it gets windy, well, we won't have anything standing.
Now, it's kind of funny, you probably can't hear it at home, but there's kind of a little hum out here because there are a lot of generators running. You can see behind me, there aren't too many lights, but actually that American Legion Hall right there is actually the Red Cross emergency shelter for the town of Breda. So a lot of residents are going there. Now, the Carroll County Emergency Management Director told me it could take up to 72 hours for power to be restored to the entire county. But again, that is up to 72 hours. Breda has been without power for 2 days so far, and many of these residents thought they were going to get power today, but they haven't. So those that do have generators, which I can hear humming, are sharing them with family members, heating up one house for a little while, heating up another house for a little while. Many residents that don't have that option of a generator are going to Carroll tonight to stay in a hotel. Some of them will go to that Red Cross shelter behind me, and other ones, they're just hoping to stick it out. Stacy and Kevin.
All right, Carrie Gavin, incredible stories and incredible pictures. Thank you very much.